with the mantra. I did the Astra Vidya. It is I learned Astra Vidya in my last life, the former life. Immediately the grand form of Chandra Maharaj came, blazing light and huge, about 7 to 8 feet tall. But when he was sitting, I had to look up at him like this. He filled that whole wall. So I did pranam to Chandra Maharaj, was the person who did tapasya of Shiv here. And because Shiv did come, he took the Shivling and pura ukhada. Then the lightning struck and that piece fell. That is what the saying goes. That piece of stone. And that's why you see that this temple is the only temple which has no Shivling. It just has the Jaldhari. Chandra Maharaj took out the Shivling. And he must have put it in his jholi and taken it with him. No Shivling. Shivling is only astral and spiritual. So the spiritual ball of light is still there, the sphere, the pillar of light. Then after that, for many, many hours, then I went into a different state. My testosterone is still heaving with that kusti. I was so suffocated that I was feeling that I'm going to die, but later on I was able to get him. And then I saw a scintillating white blue star. That's all. When I saw that, I felt satisfied. All fear went away. And that is all. That is Shiv Goraksha Babaji. That is Lord Shiva's darshan, Gorakshanathaji darshan, but not in form, just as a scintillating white star. And many times that star has come, and those of you who have seen me, the new picture of Babaji in the book, have you seen the aura I've done around it? That's like the sunburst or nova, burst or supernova. It's a burst with all the radiance. That's why, that's how I see him, and this is how I had my the darshan of Shiv Goraksha Babaji. I had to pass through all these tests. And the first was the dog, then was the Dakini. That woman was actually a Dakini. And she had said, so the first time I've had a confrontation with a Dakini, pretty strong people. They are yoginis and they do sadhana also. They're not just nonsense. They are in the Shamshan Ghats and the places. The Dakinis are very strong spiritually. So any old person cannot come and, like, suppose says, I'll do it, I want to imitate Guru Nath. You can't imitate, you'll be caught by the pants and thrown out. But you have a potential and you too can improve. When you get to that stage, you will be like Guru Nath. Each one of you, why not? But the only thing I'm cautioning you is misproportion. You're trying to run before you walk. That's all I'm saying. Don't try to run before you walk. You will all get to power. You have to be persistent.
Ah.